Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Virat Kohli, captain of the Indian cricket team, is here to address the press conference. If you wish to ask a question, please raise your hand. And there are no supplementary questions. You must raise your hand again and wait for your turn. Yes, indeed. Use the mic.
So, be interested or be in the same level in South Africa. A lot of times you're given a chance of, you know, forcing an issue, but batsmen seem to respond to it, and how hard it is when games within your caps slip away because batsmen are not able to grab it.
I think you're talking about the first innings more than the second. Because I think the first innings we were in a very good position. Me and Pujji had a good partnership. We got off to a decent start. Me and Pujji had a good partnership, and then we couldn't capitalize on that. Getting a lead of 30 odd with Pujara batting through, I think, showed all of us, you know, all the batsmen in the lower order, that we could have gotten a bigger lead. So that's the only thing I can think of in this game. I don't think apart from that we did much wrong in this game throughout. England played better cricket than us, and as I said in the post-match, they deserve to win the test match. So I don't think apart from that particular factor, there's a lot that we need to think of from this test match.
Given the success more than we had in the first team, not to compare, but would you expect it more from Ashwin this
team? Well, he you know, tried his best. I mean, he bowled a lot of overs. He pitched the ball in the right areas. He didn't get the results that probably Moin did, but you know, we all go out there to give our best effort. I mean, no one wants to not do well. We all try to do well. Some innings it doesn't come off, and you know, on flat wickets, batsmen can get out. So this was one occasion where Ashwin probably couldn't. He himself would feel he couldn't get more purchase out of the wicket. Or, you know, the batsmen played well. I mean, there could be a lot of factors when you look at that situation. But yeah, Moin bowled really well. If you have to single out his performance, I think he was relentless with the areas that he bowled in and the speeds that he bowled at. So he deserved to get the wickets he got eventually.
You know, that in batsmen, you know, you're in a great position. You were disappointed, not in the series as well. You were disappointed with anything that you batsmen.
Well, as I mentioned in the first question, we, you know, it's very difficult to recognize key moments in the first innings of a test match, but they turn out to be very big moments eventually in the course of the whole game. And I thought, as I mentioned, after I got out, you know, I myself felt that if I had batted for longer, the lead could have been bigger. But even after that, we thought we could get a couple of more partnerships and extend the lead if possible. Eventually, Pujara had to play a blinder to get us to a lead of 30-odd. So that's the only thing I feel, that we could have extended our lead a bit more in this first innings. Apart from that, as I said, as a captain, I don't see many areas that we need to think of as negatives, because we tried our best. We definitely you know, pushed England to earn a victory. And they played better cricket than us for longer periods, and that's why they won the match.
You have such high goals for this team. You're winning abroad in South Africa, 2-0 down and then 2-0 down again. Just going forward, I mean, why do you think, does something need to change, or do you have to reassess on why the first, the start of the series, if this probably hasn't been able to match the standard?
Yeah, look, we've spoken about that. We've spoken about the fact that even during the match, when we are in a driving position, we should be able to capitalize on it and not let the opposition come in and then have to fight back again and again. So yeah, we can take a leaf out of that. Nottingham did that really well. For 3 days, we were relentless and we were on top. So we need to think about how to start a series like that as well. As a group, we need to be more relentless when we start a series, and, you know, be a bit more expressive and be a bit more fearless at the beginning of a series, especially a long series, because, as I said, at the start of the series, it's there, you have time to come back. But you want to come back when you played fearless cricket, and you don't want to be catching up too much. So yeah, those things we definitely need to talk about as a team, that how we begin well in a series and not have to fight back again and again. Because I don't think we need to prove to anyone that we have the ability. Because not many teams come close to us when we play at home. But to make the home sides earn victories against us, it's a huge boost for us. Whether people want to look at it or not, that's something that we can't control. But as a group, we definitely feel that, you know, we have pushed the home side to earn victories and we haven't thrown in the towel.
I feel like 3-1 is a fair reflection on the series. You feel like the two sides and the four matches have been much closer.
Well, look, as cricket journalists, all of you, and as cricketers, we understand that a series is not always defined by the scorecard. That's just a thing to look at. You know, you might be 3-0 up in a 5-match ODI series and then the opposition wins the last two and you can say it was a close series, but it's actually not close. But when you're going seesaw in every game apart from Lords, I would not count that, then you understand that, you know, it was a competitive and hard-fought series victory for England. And Joe felt the same thing. He told me at the post-match that it might not look like it, but it's been a very close series and it's been very competitive, which I totally agree with. And that's something that as a team we feel as well. I mean, the scorecard not always reflects the way the series has gone, because it only, you know, puts in victories and losses. But the process also has been very competitive and it's been a very, I would say, enjoyable so far. It's been a hard-fought series. Well, amazing. I mean, the crowds have been really good all over the place. So, I mean, we see that everywhere. I don't see anything different here, because every stadium, people come out and support their home team, which is great to see. I think all of the test playing nations should look at it and learn from it, how to get in behind your team, how to make life difficult for the opposition. And, you know, come in huge numbers, and everyone understands the sport, they understand situations, and you can sense it. You're not only playing against 11 people, you're playing against the whole stadium, because they make you feel like you're in a difficult situation, and they'll make sure that they let you know as well. So, yeah, I'm sure for the home team it's great.
Two more questions.
Gerald, you've been playing against Murray Ali quite a bit, obviously several teams level. There's been your teammate at Bangalore as well. You've seen lots of them in India, and you've also seen best of the 4 years ago here, and also this time. Have you got any theories as to why he's such a sort of wildly fluctuating player in terms of his
performance? I don't know, I just really like the guy. I've never sat down and analysed his career. We never speak about cricket too much, because he's such a lovely guy to talk to. We generally talk about other things. But yeah, he's got good skills. That's why he's been around for so long. That's why he was picked in the IPL as well. He's definitely a very talented cricketer. We've never really had a chat about the ups and downs. You know, that's not an area for me to go and discuss with him. But as I said, I'm sure every cricketer wants to do the best that they can for their countries, and I'm sure he's wanting to do the same. Whether it happens or not, that's a different case. So I wouldn't be the right person to analyse, you know, how Mohin's career has gone so far.
Final one.
हाँ, मतलब जब हम लोग एंड में स्कोरबोर्ड देखते हैं तो ऐसा लगता है 50 रन थे या 30 रन थे, और जैसे मैंने बोला, वो उस चीज़ को हमें तब रिकग्नाइज़ करना चाहिए जब हम सिचुएशन के बीच में हों, और ना कि बाद में. तो आई थिंक वो एक चीज़, हमें पता है कि हमने अच्छी क्रिकेट खेली है, लेकिन हम बार बार ये नहीं बोल सकते अपने आप को कि हाँ हमने कम्पीट किया, क्योंकि जब हम इतना पास होते हैं रिज़ल्ट के, तो लाइन क्रॉस करने का भी एक आर्ट है जो हमें सीखना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि हमें एबिलिटी है तभी हम रिज़ल्ट के पास आ रहे हैं, और हमको उस एबिलिटी में बिलीफ भी है. बट जब प्रेशर सिचुएशन आती है तो उसमें हम कैसा रिएक्ट करते हैं, उस चीज़ पे आई थिंक हमें और थोड़ा काम करना है, और जो कि सब लोग करने को रेडी हैं, और हमें ऐसा बिल्कुल भी फील नहीं होता है, और अभी भी हमें ऐसा फील नहीं हो रहा है कि लास्ट टेस्ट मैच में हमें इंटेंसिटी से नहीं खेलना है, क्योंकि हमने यहाँ पे क्रिकेट खेलने इन्जॉय किया है, हमने यहाँ पे क्रिकेट को बर्डन की तरह नहीं लिया और हम लोग लास्ट टेस्ट में भी वो ही जाके करेंगे जो हमने हर टेस्ट मैच में किया, और एक अपॉर्चुनिटी है अपनी गलतियों को इम्प्रूव करने का और आगे के लिए सीखने का कि जब, जैसे मैंने बोला कि प्रेशर सिचुएशन आएगी तो उसको कैसे कैपिटलाइज करना है, तो हम ज़रूर कोशिश करेंगे कि लास्ट टेस्ट मैच में उसको ठीक करें।
थैंक यू कैप्टन।